Hello, welcome. Today we are going to be looking at variety of organic compounds. I told us that we have up to 3,000 different types of organic compounds. So we are going to be looking at why is it that carbon is able to have so many compounds to be able to be called organic chemistry. Organic chemistry is just the chemistry of only carbon and its compound. Why is it that carbon has so many compounds? So we are going to look at the presence of numerous organic compounds. What is the reason for having numerous organic compounds? First of all, organic compounds are compounds that are composed of number one thing is what? Carbon. Number two is oxygen and what? Hydrogen. Number three is nitrogen, sulfur, halogens, and in some rare cases, we have something like metals on carbon. So we look at organic compounds are composed of number one, carbon, number two, hydrogen and oxygen. Number three, elements such as nitrogen, sulfur, halogens, phosphorus, and sometimes metals. You understand? So that's how you identify an organic compound when you see them. First of all, that it must contain carbon. Then in most cases, it can contain hydrogen and what? Or oxygen. Then in some cases, few times, it can contain nitrogen, sulfur, halogen, and phosphorus. And in few cases, it can have what? Metals. So why is it that carbon is able to form many organic compounds? What nature of carbon that enables that? Number one, carbon's ability to form single, double, and triple what? Covalent bonds. I told us that carbon can easily form single, double, and what? Triple covalent bonds. Using the same number of carbon atoms, like 5, you can have a structure that has a single bond, pentane. You can have the one that have a double bond, 2-methyl and butane. You can have the one that has ring like benzene and other ones. You understand? So carbon can be in all this nature. And I told you that the reason for this is because of the hybridization of the N orbital. Now we have ability of carbon atoms to catenate. Carbon has the ability to do what? Catenate. Catenation simply means to combine with one another in order to form straight chain, branch chain, and what? Ring chain compound containing many carbon atoms. Carbon has the ability to do what? Catenate. Catenation. Ability to bond with other carbon atoms to form straight chain hydrocarbons, branch chain hydrocarbons, and ring hydrocarbons. Now, the other character is because of the ease with which carbon combine with hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, and what? Halogen. Carbon combine easily with nitrogen, oxygen, halogen, and other these things. Then another thing is that the bond energy per carbon-carbon single bond is high, 3-4-6. So it makes carbon-carbon bond to be very stable. Then we look at characteristic features of organic compounds. How do you know organic compounds when you see them? Number one, organic compounds are flammable. They are highly what? Flammable. They can burn, they can explode. That's why you can use fuel to burn things. You can use it to drive car. Because when fuel burns in the engine, it just develops energy that the car can use to move. Reactivity. Reactions of organic compounds are slow. You understand? Organic compounds have low melting and what? Boiling point because of the weak intermolecular forces between them. They are covalent in nature. You know that carbon has 4 outer electrons, so they form covalent bonds. Organic compounds are not soluble in polar solvents, but they are soluble in non-polar solvents. Example of non-polar solvent is benzene and ether. Benzene and what? Ether. Both of them are non-polar. So that's where you can, if you want to dissolve any organic compound like fuel and all those things, you cannot dissolve them in water. You understand? Fuel is not soluble in water. All those things, they are not soluble in water, but they are soluble in non-polar what? Solvents like benzene and what? Ether. So these are the characteristics of organic compounds. They have low melting and boiling points. They are covalent in nature. They are polarity. They are not polar. They are non-polar. Yes. And their solubility, they are only soluble in non-polar what? Compound. They are flammable, highly flammable. If you see where they are keeping hydrocarbons, they will write, please don't, they are highly flammable. You don't have to use matchbox or anything around that area. Reactivity, they are very, very slow in reaction. Exactly. So we've been able to cover the reason for the availability of numerous organic compounds and the characteristics of organic compounds. Thank you.